We will start with a line of symmetry. Then on this line, we will input 2 points, so the distance between them is 6. Then from those points, we will construct 2 circles so that they are intersecting at 2 points. Now from the centers of our 2 circles and their intersection points, we will construct a rectangle so that the height of this rectangle is parallel to the line of symmetry. If our 2 circles have the area of 9 pi and 25 pi, is it possible for us to calculate this red shaded area of our rectangle? If you want to try this interesting problem for yourself, this would be a great time to pause the video and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this one. So, we're going to use 2 different methods to solve this problem. First, we are going to use the pure geometry method. We are first going to start by labeling the centers of our 2 circles as A and B, then we are going to label their intersection points as C and D. Now we are going to pull the line from C to D, and we are going to mark the intersection point between this line and our line of symmetry as O. Now let's focus on our 2 circles. Let's label the radius of our small circle as r. This means that the area of this circle is equal to r squared pi. Since we know that the area is equal to 9 pi, we can substitute that and get that the radius of this circle is equal to 3. We can do the same thing for our bigger circle. We can label its radius as a capital R and get that the area of this circle must be equal to capital R squared pi. Now we can substitute the value of the area of this circle, and after simplification, we will get that the radius of this circle is equal to 5. Now we can rotate the radii of both of our circles to the point D. And by doing this, we have formed this really nice triangle ADB. Now let's label the line OD as X. But this line will actually represent the height of this triangle, since the angle at the point O is a right angle. But how do we know this? Well, we know this by using the property of the common chord, which states that the common chord of 2 circles is normal to the straight line passing through the center of these circles. So, we're going to use this in our case here, since the line CD is a common chord, and line AB is a line through both centers. Alright, so now we're going to zoom into this triangle for better understanding. Then we're going to replace the values of small r and capital R, and we're going to label the segment OB as P and OA as Q. Now, from here we can easily see that the sum of P and Q must be equal to 6. So, we can say that P must be equal to 6 minus Q. Then we can notice this really neat right triangle ODB. We can use the Pythagorean theorem to find the leg X, so X squared is equal to hypotenuse 3 squared minus leg P squared. Now we can substitute the value of P, which we got earlier, and we will get the following. Here we can expand by using the square of binomial, and we can simplify this to get the following equation. Now, let's set our attention to another right triangle, ODA. We can again use the Pythagorean theorem for x to get that x squared is equal to 5 squared minus q squared, which means that x squared is equal to 25 minus q squared. We can now substitute the value of x squared in our previous equation, and we will get only one unknown, q. Now we can simplify this by cancelling minus q squared on both sides of the equation, and after we work through this, we will get that 12q is equal to 52, which means that q is equal to 52 over 12, and we can simplify this to 13 over 3. Alright, so now we're going to again replace the value of q into our Pythagorean theorem to get the value of x. So, we're going to simplify this, and then we're going to find the common denominator, in order to get that x squared is equal to 56 over 9, which means that x must be equal to square root of 56 over 3. This value actually really nicely approximates to 2.5. Alright, so now since we have the value of x, we will unzoom our triangle and get our previous image back. We know that the line AB is a line of symmetry, which means that the segment OD and OC must have the same length. So that means that OC must also have the value of x. Therefore, since our rectangle has the length of CD, this means that this length must be equal to 2x. Now, it's easy to find the area of our red rectangle, since the area is equal to the product of the length and the height. So, in our case, that is 2x times 6. We can substitute the value of x, and we will finally get that the area of our red rectangle is approximately 30 squared units, and this is our solution. Alright, so now let's try the method number 2. In this method, we will use analytical geometry to solve this problem. We're going to start by drawing the coordinate system xy through the center of our bigger circle. Then, in order to solve our problem, we're going to use the equation of a circle, which states that the quantity of x minus a squared plus the quantity of y minus b squared must be equal to r squared, where a and b represents the coordinates of the center of the circle and r represents the radius of a circle. So, let's do this for both of our circles. First, let's concentrate on our bigger circle. From the previous method, we already have the value of the radius of this circle to be equal to 5, so we're not going to calculate this all over again. Then we will notice that the center of this circle is located at the coordinate beginning, so this means that the coordinates of our center is 0, 0. Now, we can substitute those values into our equation of a circle to get the following. We can simplify this and get that x squared plus y squared is equal to 25, which represents the equation of this bigger circle. Now, let's set our attention on our smaller circle. Like before, from the previous method, we know that the radius of this circle is equal to 3, and you can notice that the center of this circle is located at the y-axis and at the height of 6, which means that the coordinates of the center of this circle must be 0 and 6. We will substitute those values into the equation of a circle, and after simplification, we will get the following. Now, we will use these two equations of a circles to form the system of equations, from which we will get the points of intersections between those two circles, which we will label as P and Q. It is pretty easy to solve this system if you notice that the value of x plus y squared is repeated in both of those equations. So we are going to just substitute this value as 25 and get the following. Now we can simplify this and finally get that the coordinate y must be equal to 13 over 3. Now we can just substitute this value into our first equation and get that x squared plus 13 over 3 squared is equal to 25. We can now put everything on a square and find the common denominator, after which we will get that x squared is equal to 56 over 9, which means that x must be equal to plus minus square root of 56 over 3. Alright, so in this way, we got the coordinates for both of our intersection points P and Q. Now, in order to find the length of our rectangle, we must find the value of the line PQ. And this is pretty easy to find, since the value of the coordinate Y is the same for both points. So, in order to find the value PQ, we can just find the absolute value of the difference between their x coordinates. And we will get that this is equal to 2 times square root of 56 over 3. This value really neatly approximates to 5. Now we can find the area of our rectangle. Since this area is equal to the line PQ, which represents the length of this rectangle, times the height 6. We can substitute the value of PQ and finally get that the area of our red rectangle is approximately 30 squared units, and this is our solution. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like and consider subscribing to the channel. It really means a lot. And of course, until next time, see you all and take care.